selected, the people that we have in our reserve champion selected. Let's give the judges a nice round of applause for bringing out a nice full team effort. It's really kind of neat when we go from our cap class all the way up through our junior senior yearlings and get into our head mature efforts, and certainly one that's going to be freshening here near the end of the month, and we're not that far away from the 20th, so they're going to be keeping an eye on her every day from here on out. One of the things that I remember most, and one of the things that I cherish the most, is my time that I got to spend with a different breed than you're working with out here in Holstein. I grew up with Jerseys in Northeast Iowa, and so I'm a bit partial, but certainly I don't have to worry about that today. I do appreciate the Holsteins for what they were, what they are, and what they've become, a very, very efficient milking machine. And talking about some possibilities of where the dairy industry is going, you know, you talk about the milk production on a 205 or 305 milk production, and you start looking at some cows, and whether you look at the Holstein Journal or not, are pushing some very, very fancy numbers, some that are almost unbelievable for somebody who grew up in the dairy industry. But I do cherish my moments in the dairy industry, certainly most of all I cherish the time that I got to spend in the milk barn. And certainly we had stanchions, and I'm sure that's not the wave of the future. That's a thing of the past. But I remember milking about 40 to 50 head every day, morning and night. And so it is one of those things that I do think that it taught me a little bit about work ethic. I also had some people that were very good teachers as far as the show ring was concerned. And I appreciate that about them. And so I've tried to talk to each one of your kids. It may have left them a bit frustrated in terms of the way they're showing. And that's because it's different than anything else you've done before, and certainly one of those things that I am very, very select on. Both my daughters got a chance to show Holsteins when they were in school, and certainly I'm very proud of where they've gone from that time. But I do want you to know I appreciate these kids. I know that the effort is, you got to work with them, and we've got a lot more competition for kids' times today than we did when I was a kid, and I understand that. But certainly I don't think that should take away from some of the heritage and some of the things we learned in terms of showing dairy cattle. I appreciate that about. In this particular final drive between you for your champion, and we do have the champion reserve out here in front of us, I do want to compliment those people, and particularly I am extremely complimentary of the two-year-old over here. She will be your champion at this stage of the game. I think she's close to freshening. We like that about her. We change some things in immediately in that loin area, but that's where your tongue comes in handy. So if you want to keep her top up, you have to work at it just a little bit. I think the question becomes reserved in my mind. I don't think there's a little choice, at least in here for me. I really admire the heifer that we've got out here in the third class. I think if we were to see her come back as a two-year-old, I think quite frankly, she might very well dominate the show. So. She's my compliment. I do compliment her a great deal. I think hopefully you've learned something. I do appreciate the opportunity to work with your dairy. We've got some showmanship classes. But certainly your champion female is down there on the end of the two-year-old, and the senior yearling will be your class three, will be your reserve champion. Let's give them a nice round of applause.
Thank So champion dairy female goes to David Ware with his Holstein cow. Reserve champion dairy female goes to Danny Haynes.
She's standing now for you.